ಹರೇ ಶ್ರೀನಿವಾಸ, ವೆಲ್ಕಮ್ ಟು ಮಂಗಳಾಚರಣ ಸಂಧಿ ಫೋರ್ತ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್. ಚತುರವದನನ ರಾಣಿ ಅತಿರೋ ಹಿತ ವಿಮಲ ವಿಜ್ಞಾನಿ ನಿಗಮ ಪ್ರತತಿಗಳಿಗಭಿಮಾನಿ ವೀಣಾ ಪಾಣಿ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮಾಣಿ. ನತಿಸಿ ಬೇಡುವೆ ಜನನಿ ಲಕುಮಿ ಪತಿಯ ಗುಣಗಳ ತುತಿ ಪುದಕೆ ಸನ್ ಮತಿಯ ಪಾಲಿಸಿ ನೆಲೆಸು ನೀಮದ್ವದನ ಸದನದಲ್ಲಿ. ಶ್ರೀ ಸರಸ್ವತಿ ದೇವಿ, ದ ವಾಣಿ ದೇವಿ, ಈಸ್ ದ ಸ್ಪೌಸ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ನರ್ ಆಫ್ ಫೋರ್ ಹೆಡ್ಡೆಡ್ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮದೇವರು. ದೇ ಆರ್ ಮೇಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಈಚ್ ಅದರ್. ಶ್ರೀ ವಾಣಿ ದೇವಿ ಈಸ್ ಬಿಲಾಂಗಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಕಕ್ಷಾ ಫೋರ್, ದ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ ಫೋರ್. ದ ಕಕ್ಷಾ ತ್ರೀ ಈಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ರುಜು ಸೋಲ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕಕ್ಷಾ ಫೋರ್ ಈಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ದೇರ್ ಸ್ಪೌಸಸ್. The four-headed Brahma and Saraswati are referred as first couples among all the souls in the created universe. Mother Lakshmi and Narayana are eternal couples at all the time. The Rujugana and their corresponding spouses are having much higher knowledge compared to all other souls in the universe, starting from Kaksha 5 onwards. Their knowledge is infallible at any given point of time. It is not liable to err. Even during Mahapralaya, the final dissolution, during Mahapralaya, all the souls will be in deep prolonged sleep, whereas those Ruju couples, the Ruju yogis, will be meditating upon the Lord Srihari. Being Rizvi, the spouse of Ruju Brahma, she enjoys with the highest level of Hari knowledge. It is continuous knowledge without any flaws. Her knowledge is not like ups and downs, like the peaks and downs of ocean waves. Main presiding deity of Veda is Mother Mahalakshmi. Next to Mahalakshmi is Sri Saraswati as Vedabhimani Devata. Saraswati is having a music instrument called Veena in her hands. The Veena with Saraswati is called as Kachapi, very famous one. We also know that Narada Maharshi is also always holding a Veena. It is called as Mahati Veena. During the creation of universe, the Supreme Lord took four Vyuha forms. After 3 years of birth of four-headed Brahma, the Vyuha couples Kruti and Pradyumna got a child, Saraswati. She is called then as Prakruti. Four-headed Brahma is chanting Vedas with all his four heads, four mouths. Being his spouse, Vani also will chant Veda mantra spontaneously. As Saraswati is well-versed with all the Veda mantras, she is called as Brahmani. She is also spouse of Brahma, so Brahmani too. Brahma also meaning Tattva. She is being Brahmani, is in charge of higher level of Tattvas. She is knower of all other lower tattvas, much more than presiding deities of respective tattva. It is of course the inherent knowledge level of Ruji Yogins. She is Abhimanini for the highest tattva, the Avyakta tattva as well. Any student before pursuing the studies will seek blessings of Saraswati. She is called as Vidya Surupini. She will bestow knowledge, Hari Bhakti, Guru Bhakti to her devotees. To get Vakshuddhi, outspoken knowledge, one should have blessings of Mother Saraswati. The blessed person will get best knowledge. Kruti Ramana Pradyumna Nandane Chaturavimshati Tattva Patide Vategalige Guru Venusutiha Marutana Nijapatni. ಸತತ ಹರಿಯಲಿ ಗುರುಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಸದೃತಿಯ ಪಾಲಿಸಿ ಭಾಗವತ ಭಾ ರಥಪುರಾಣ ರಹಸ್ಯ ತತ್ವಗಳರುಪು ಕರುಣದಲಿ. ಭಾರತಿ ದೇವಿ ಈಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಎ ರುಜ್ವಿ. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಸರಸ್ವತಿ ದೇವಿ, ಶಿ ಇಸ್ ಸ್ಪೌಸ್ ಟು ವಾಯುದೇವರು. ಶಿ ಇಸ್ ಬಾರ್ನ್ ಟು ವ್ಯೂಹರೂಪ ಕಪಲ್ ಕೃತಿ ಪ್ರದ್ಯುಮ್ನ ದೇವ. ಶಿ ಹ್ಯಾಸ್ ಬಾರ್ನ್ ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಸರಸ್ವತಿ ಈಸ್ ಬಾರ್ನ್ ಟು ಕೃತಿ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಪ್ರದ್ಯುಮ್ನ ದೇವ. She is in the fourth kaksha too. As such, naturally, her knowledge is pure and without any flaws. She is superior to all other tattvabhimanis of lower order. She is the guru, master to them all. Her spouse, Vayudevaru, is called as Jivottama, resides within all the physical bodies of souls and perform the Hamsa Japa. It is a breathing exercise required to sustain life in all the physical bodies of souls. Naturally, Bharata Devi will be also with her spouse, Vayudevaru, in all physical bodies of all the souls. Dasaru prays Bharata Devi to grant a good mind to us for listening, chanting and understanding of the greatness of Sri Hari. Bharata Devi will make our mind pure by cleansing it with worldly attachments. By her grace, our mind will be purified and will be directed towards the path of God realization. On behalf of we all, Dasaru is praying Bharata Devi to grant us, bless us with the knowledge to understand Bhagavata, Mahabharata, Puranas and all other Sadagamas. To understand the real meaning of all these great Granthas, one should have obtained the affection, boon, blessings, anugraha by Bharata Devi. It is must. It is very, very difficult to have true meanings of those great books. Our knowledge is not at all sufficient. That's why her anugraha is most essential. With her blessings, one can understand the sayings of great books. One can understand the rahasya, hidden meanings of those all. 18 Puranas, Upapuranas and mighty Mahabharata of 1 lakh slokas are all written by Lord Vedavyasaru. Those are all narrated by three types of explanation of language schemes called bhashas. They are three: Samadhi Bhasha, Darsana Bhasha and Guhya Bhasha. Samadhi Bhasha, this style of narration will provide direct information to a common person. The main theme of all the Granthas works is to narrate the greatness of Lord Sri Hari. This is Samadhi Bhasha. The Darsana Bhasha, it is a type of narration which include the information of other philosophies too, thinking, themes and guidelines of them. This is further divided into two information module. One, to narrate as seen by a common person, Loka Darsana Bhasha, and second one is to narrate other philosophies as it is. It is to narrate Paradarsana Bhasha. This is required for one who is going to take knowledge, going to gather knowledge. And next is Guhya Bhasha. This is entirely different and alien to above mentioned Bhashas. Very, very difficult. At the outset, it appears to be rejected by one and all, as it is entirely appearing to be directing totally in wrong direction. But only on thorough thinking one can conclude that it is worth, full of gems hidden, full of informations with themes and most essentially suitably worded and with the right direction to knowledge. This all analysis is must for any student of philosophy. By the grace of Bharata Devi, one can understand this and move in right path. Veda Pitha Virinchi Bhava Shakradi Sura Vidnana Dayaka Moda Chinmaya Gatra Loka Pavitra Sucharitra Cheda Veda Vishada Kutilam Tadi Madhya Vidura Ada Nadikarana Badarayana Pahi Satranam. Vedas are eternal. The Vedas will provide true knowledge of Sri Hari. Even though Vedas are eternal, they will be brought to light during the creation of Brahmanda and will be condensed to Pranava during Mahapralaya, the final dissolution of world by Sri Hari. Sri Hari incarnated as Badarayanaru, as Vedavyasaru during the last stage of Dwapara Yuga. He divided Vedas into four groups. He is bestower of Veda knowledge to his eldest son Brahmadevaru and to all the Tattvabhimani Devatas. The Kali Yuga will be more with ignorance and false knowledge. The souls born in this Kali Yuga will be subjected to misery, wrong direction and wrong knowledge. By knowing this in advance, Lord Vedavyasa set guidelines for the study of Vedas, Upanishads, Puranas and so on. He established departments separately for each branches. The university study system started from him onwards. He posted scholars to head each departments. The Vedic Parampara generation started from him. He trained many students to the highest level and posted to different departments. To quote a few, Paila, Sumantu, Vaishampayana, Jaimini, Angirasa, Shuka, Narada, Romaharshana, Bhrugu, Sanat Kumara, etc., etc., etc. To quote few departments established by Padarayanaru and the incharges, Rishi Paila for Rugveda branch, Jaimini for Karma Mimamsa, Angirasa for Atharva Veda, Yoga Shastras, Bhrugumani, Mahabharata, Vaishampayana. The practice of yagas and different deeds, karmas, practices were established and continued by Romaharshanaru. And teachings imparting knowledge to human beings and Gandharvas was established, continued by Shukamuni, Shukacharyaru. So we can take Shukamuni is the first vice chancellor of human universities. Thus, every Guru Parampara traces its roots to Vedarayana, Badarayana, the Vedavyasa. He is the purifier of universe. With blessings of Vedavasaru, the Guru Parampara become pure, fine, and followed by human society. He also set guidelines for the puja, the worship methods. He will provide pure energy, knowledge to his devotees, so he is called as Satrana. Lord Badarayana cannot be cut or split by any weapons. He cannot be made unhappy by any events. He is the happiest mighty mountain at all the time. He is not at all subjected to destruction, disease and death. He is not in the cycle of birth, death, birth. He is Lord himself. O Badarayana, please protect us. Salutation to you. Now let us listen to Harikathamsara Padya by pressing the button, the link provided below. This is an initiative of Bharatiya Haridasa Sahitya Vidyalaya Bangalore. We are in service of Haridasa Sahitya since 25 long years. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna.